hope you're having a fantastic day. We are in the middle of quarantine and it's a great chance to get out and enjoy nature. Today we're actually going to be talking about one of El Paso's most surprising and yet beautiful scenes it has to offer.
El Paso sits right at the edge of the Franklin Mountains, at the tip of Texas, right up against the border of Juarez, Mexico, and New Mexico. It's part of the Chihuahuan Desert, the largest and also most biologically diverse desert in North America, and stereotypically known as desert wasteland that most would describe as brown, or even referred to as the moon in the popular movie Glory Road, when recruited UTEP basketball players first saw the desolate desert of El Paso. But the Chihuahuan Desert has its hidden gems, and once a year in March, poppy flowers sprout up along the east side of the Franklin Mountains. And this year, in 2020, when we probably needed the distraction the most, the desert turned into fields of gold. Unfortunately, the annual Poppy Festival did have to be canceled, which is too bad because this is one of the best blooms that we've ever seen. Thousands flock to Trans Mountain Drive to experience this breathtaking view, but few know much about the poppies and their story. The poppies are in fact not a natural occurrence, and there are many myths surrounding how they got here. Everything from Japanese gardeners to newlyweds or a mourning widow have been credited for spreading the seeds. The evidence we do have is that in 1931, E.L. Saunders, who was president of the Chamber of Commerce, started a campaign to raise money for poppy plants. He believed that if they were able to plant these flowers on the slopes of the Franklin Mountains, it would become an attraction like the Blue Bonnets of Texas or the caverns at Carlsbad. Well, he wasn't wrong, and his idea was successful. He did manage to raise the money, and it is believed that groups such as the Boy Scouts, the women's groups, and even a poppy club helped with this. It's unclear exactly who helped him spread the seeds, but many believe that a veteran flew his small plane over the 10-mile range, spreading the poppies in honor of those who had lost their lives in World War I. After World War I, poppies had become a symbol used by veterans in remembrance of fallen soldiers, after Lieutenant Colonel John McCree wrote his famous poem about seeing the beautiful poppies growing over the battlefield, where all types of carnage had destroyed the ground, plants, and trees. Despite the fact that the poppies didn't arrive here naturally, they are in fact thriving. Poppies love the type of soil that is in this region, making it a great place for them to grow. And although they don't like very hot temperatures, the plants can actually go dormant and wait for cooler weather. But you're probably wondering why, in 2020, the El Paso poppies are having one of their best blooms in at least 10 years. Poppies are a hardy flower, even considered a weed. Seed pods burst forcefully, scattering seeds a long distance, and with wind and water, they can travel even further. Seeds will often remain dormant for years, waiting for the seed coat to be removed with enough water. This means that seeds can wait 5 years or longer for enough rainfall to germinate and grow. The poppy plants covering the mountainside like yellow paint have waited years to grow. This last winter received a lot of rain, and it has made for a beautiful spring. While you're out enjoying the poppies, remember that you are asked not to pick them, since those flowers are needed to repopulate the area for the future, and plants are also poisonous to people and pets.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to share this with your friends.